Mr. and Mrs. Guerrero. The chairman told us about what you did. We appreciate you coming here in our humble community. We apologize for not getting back earlier, but we had to respond to a fire in the next town.
Someone from the municipal hall called for help. That's why we're here. What's important is that everything turned out fine.
Don't worry, ma'am. You can both take your rest now. We'll take it from here and continue with the search. Can you give us an update on the status of your operation?
Well, fortunately, sir, there were no casualties from the landslide that occurred. Our rescue team was able to save all those people who were buried. 26 of them got injured and had to be taken to the hospital, but every one of them were already taken by our ambulances to nearby hospitals.
Is that so? That's great news, sir. Again, thank you so much for your help.
Thanks to you too, sir.
I'll go ahead. Hurry up and unload the whole thing.
Thank goodness no one died today. And thank you for letting us help in the rescue.
Anna, I'm also happy that I was able to help people. But sadly, you almost got in trouble.
I know that, but nothing happened. I'm really sorry. I can't stop myself from helping out.
Look at them. All of them are in this situation because of those wretched Del Mundos. Their greed is too much for the people to bear.
Don't worry, Xander. We will take them all down, okay? What matters now is that we were able to help these people. But I promise you this. We'll be able to get justice for all the victims of the Del Mundo's crimes.
Will you just look at Samantha? She's really good at making up stories. I can use that for my campaign. Those kinds of stories, that's what the masses love to hear and read.
The organic reach is rapidly increasing. I don't even have to call our troll factory to help boost its views. But let's talk about what happened at the community. The damage was undeniably huge. We have to start all over again, from the beginning, Salvador. Are we going to continue the community development plan?
Yes, of course. We can even use that video to prove I'm not doing this just to gain popularity and votes.
The medics and doctors who responded to the landslide, they're from the company of the Guerreros, right?
Yes.
I just can't imagine how lucky we are that they were exactly right where we needed them to be, don't you think so?
Well, they seem to be trustworthy. Why don't we make them our partners in our endeavors?
One operation is not enough to say that they're trustworthy, Salvador. What do we know about them aside from their background? For the past 10 years, they disappeared without a trace. We don't even know what they did during that time. And to top it all, no one can say where they were all those years.
Come on, Miranda. Past is past. All I know is that I can use them. In fact, I can make up a story to make it look like I was the one who sent them there.
Salvador, I'm not comfortable with them.
Just call them, Miranda.
Dad.
Oh,
Mom.
Hey. There's my hero! You're a real hero, dear. You're amazing. You're even able to save someone even if you're pregnant. I'm so proud of you. Huh?
Thank you, Dad.
I'm not the only hero in this family.
Come on, Missy. I can't understand why she did that.
Hey, what's happening here?
I can't believe you're asking us that question.
Yvonne.
Would you care to explain what really happened? Why were you in San Sebastian? Are you out of your mind?
Hey, Yvonne, that's enough already, okay? I already talked to Anna about this, and she didn't do anything that would make Gael suspicious of her.
Are you sure about that? Because Gael watches Anna's every move like a vulture waiting for its prey to weaken.
He didn't notice anything, but he kept on pestering me.
Anna, what's important is that next time, if you can't help but do something impulsive and totally out of our plan, you should at least inform the team about it, so they'll know how they can help you. And as for you, Xander, you should have told Anna about the consequences of her actions.
Missy, I explained everything to her about what might happen, but it was really Anna who insisted to do it anyway.
I'm sorry, it's my fault. It just so happened that they really needed help. I couldn't just turn a blind eye.
Well, I don't want to appear like I'm controlling you, Sam. I'm just worried about our baby.
Ka'eli, come on now. I'm the one carrying our baby. Of course I won't let anything happen to it.
Sorry. I hope I'm not interrupting.
Mom.
No, Aunt. Actually, we're about to leave now.
Gael, I'd like to speak to my daughter in private.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, Mom? What do you want to talk about?
About you. Going to the mining site.
Mom. My goodness, you know why I did that, right?
Yes. Because of Gael. Dear, your world shouldn't revolve around him just because he's your husband now. He has a point. He's right. You have to think about your safety and your baby.
I get your point. I shouldn't have let my emotions get to me. But the baby's fine, Mom, and I was just worried something might happen to Gael.
Well, you had me worried back there. I was scared something bad might happen to you, dear.
I know you love Gael very much, but please, don't you ever forget how much I love you too, my daughter.
I never want you to get hurt, Samantha. So please, don't do that again.
Fine. Okay, Mom.
Uncle,
aren't you going to get some rest, boy? You really had a tough day today.
Well, I can't stop thinking about what happened earlier at the site. It's like I was back being a soldier again. There are so many people who needed help. But Anna...
What about her?
Anna knew exactly what to do, Uncle, and who to help, who should be rescued. You know what? She's quietly working in the shadows, instructing people what they should do. Well, it's just amazing that even though she's pretending to be Stella, I could see in her eyes, Uncle, the determination to help other people, you know? Let's just say that... Yes. Yes, Uncle, she may have borrowed my wife's face, but deep down, she's still Anna.
Gael, you're still here. Why haven't you and your wife gone home yet?
She's still talking to her mom right now.
I spoke with Salvador about what happened at the town today. He was glad you took charge of the situation earlier. You handled everything well. I'm proud of you.
You know, it's too early to say that, Mom. And what if they investigate the cause of the landslide and everything leads back to us?
As long as the victims stay quiet and won't file a complaint, we won't have a problem. You've already provided them with enough assistance.
Well, I wasn't able to help that much, Mom. If there's someone who they should thank, it's Anna and not me.
You mean Stella?
No, Mom. I still believe that woman is Anna. You should have seen how she helped the victims earlier today. That's exactly how Anna used to behave.
Stella liked helping people too, didn't she?
Yes, she helped a lot of people, Uncle, but... to endanger her own life for the sake of others? She wouldn't do that.
Her own life?
Anna can't stop herself from helping other people, Uncle. There was a man left behind and was trapped in town. Gael and I went out to rescue him. We didn't know Anna was following us. She was the one who saved that man.
Did Gael happen to see her there?
No, he did not.
That's fortunate. Or else your cover would have been blown by the Del Mundos.
Well, Uncle, Anna knows what she's doing. Besides, Anna's so different from my first impression of her.
Mm-hmm.
She's more than meets the eye, Uncle. She's nothing like the person I thought she was.
You thought that she was weak. That she needs a hero to save her life. That She can't survive on her own. Is that what you're saying, Xander?
She is a good person. You know what? Earlier, as I watched her in action, my anger towards the Del Mundos only grew stronger. She doesn't deserve to be in this situation, Uncle.
I think you're just confused, son, because you've been in the same situation before with Anna. That is why you associate Anna with Stella. Well, I assure you, son, she's definitely not Anna.
Hold on, do you know where Anna is, Mom?
How would I know that, son?
I don't know. But you've said countless times that it's impossible she's Anna. It's as if you really know what happened to Anna.
Gael, I know she's not Anna, because I had that woman investigated. And Stella's telling the truth. Gael, stop living in the past, okay? Move on, son.
Let's face it, it's not easy to win their trust. But I think we're in the right direction. We're on the right track.
Well, I noticed they were delighted with your visit to San Sebastian. So I think they'll accept your offer this time.
But only then will the mission start, right?
Yes. When you earn the trust of the Del Mundos, that's when the real fight begins, okay? But Anna, don't think that it'll be easy. Getting the evidence once you're in is much harder, so you have to be careful. Always keep in mind that they'll be watching your every move like a hawk.
You don't have to worry. I know what's at stake here, and I won't blow our cover, Miss C.
Are you sure? Because your actions during the landslide say otherwise.
What are you talking about, Yvonne?
Miss C, if you're not aware yet, Anna happened to help a man. You knew that Gael was there. Why did you do that?
Is this true, Anna?
Don't deny it, Anna. I heard everything you did at the site from Xander. Don't you know that you endangered everyone's lives because of what you did back there?
I'm sorry, Miss C. Yes, I did save that man's life, but I made sure that no one would see me. You know, I couldn't just ignore someone in need of help.
So you admit it then, huh? That you don't care about this mission. You're so selfish, Anna.
Yvonne...
You just do whatever the heck you think is right, am I correct?
I know what the mission is, Yvonne. I know what we need to do, okay? But if you can help someone in need, then you should do it and do it without thinking twice. You know, we shouldn't just focus on this mission, guys. Aren't you forgetting that the reason that we're doing this is because we want to help other people? If that's not the case, then we're no different from Salvador and his empty promises.
But you've done this a couple of times already. You always put our lives
in... Okay, enough already! Listen, you two arguing with each other won't do us any good, okay? Anna, I know you want to help other people in whatever way you can. There's really nothing wrong with that. But do remember this. You'll be helping a lot more people out there if we take down Salvador Del Mundo. And you, Yvonne, for crying out loud, will you please stop accusing Anna like she's not even making sacrifices for all these missions? Anna's been a lot of help to us, okay?
It is estimated that 300 families are scattered in different evacuation centers. Some of them could not be accommodated, so they set up tents for temporary shelter around the area. Apparently, some of these families would like...
Why did you turn off the TV? I want to know why a landslide occurred in that area.
Grandma. Come on, we both know why there was a landslide. It's the mines owned by the Del Mundos. They're a bunch of greedy people. Don't they even think about other people?
Someone's at the door.
It's probably just Emmy, Grandma.
Hello, good evening.
It's you again. What do you need from us that you can't leave us alone?
Well, I just want to know right now if you've changed your mind. Are you ready to see your granddaughter?
We're not coming with you. No matter how many times you ask, we definitely won't change our minds.
Maybe this will help you make a decision. This was taken the other day, Grandma.
My granddaughter. Where was that taken?
Honestly, I can't tell you. Not unless you both come with me.
Grandma, I think he can help us find Anna. Why don't we go with him?
Don't let him fool you again, grandson. That's enough. Get out of here. We don't want to see you again.
Grandma, we both want to know what exactly happened to Anna. I'm pretty sure you'll eventually change your mind.
It's Salvador. Hi, Senator.
Bella, how are you?
I'm sure yesterday's operations were stressful for you and Sander. So did you get enough rest already?
Oh, Senator, thank you. Thank you for the concern. Well, yesterday's operations were rather tough, but we're very happy that we were able to help.
Oh, that's good.
Anyway, I just called because I wanted to invite you and
Sander, if you have the time, to meet up at my
office in the Senate building. My wife and I would like to discuss something with you.
About what, Senator?
It would be best if we could discuss this in person, Stella.
Okay. So can you drop by?
How about before lunch?
Well, okay then. See you, Senator.
Good. Okay. See you.
What did they say, Godfather? Are they both coming?
Yes. Seems like it.
What did he want?
Well, he wants us to go to his office.
But why?
I have no idea. He didn't say why. But there's only one possible reason.
Your proposal.
Are you sure about this, Gael?
They're still not here. How unprofessional of them to be late.
Will you relax? It's only been 3 minutes, Miranda. You're being too strict.
And you're being too lenient. You know what? We're wasting precious time here.
Please, please stop arguing. That's enough, okay? Somebody might hear you, you know?
Senator, they're already here. See?
Hey, Stella.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, everyone.
Congratulations.
For what?
Well, we thought long and hard about this. You joining us, you know, as doing a partnership. And without a doubt, we all think that you two would make a great business partner.
That's wonderful. Thank you, Senator.
And I'm also happy you changed your mind, honey. At first, he wasn't really sure about this whole partnership thing.
Actually, Gael was the one who convinced me. He made me realize that there's no reason not to accept your offer to partner with you.
Looks like you're the one we have to thank, Gael.
No need to be so formal. I'm just hoping that you will be more open with me now that we're going to work together with less secrets, that you will be willing to tell me things.
Like you're saying we're hiding a lot of secrets from you.
No. I just want to get to know our partners. I just really like being close to the people I work with.
Well, like you said, our families will be working closely together from now on, Gael. So I'm sure we'll have a lot of time to get to know each other better. Oh, by the way, thank you very much, sir. You won't regret choosing us as your partners.
Oh, you don't have to say that, Sander, because you've already proven that you can do it.
Well, I just hope you have something else to offer us, aside from rescue operations.
We're ready to support the projects of Mr. Senator. And this project is a community responsibility. We
We surely can provide doctors and medicine to the communities you'll be developing. And as long as you continue your development projects, we'll continue to help you.
That's good. Well, can you start helping me out now by accompanying me to the news station? So I can introduce you as our official partners in our endeavors, okay?
No problem, Senator. It's more than enough for you to mention us.
Well, Stella, Xander, welcome! I look forward to working with you.
Here's the contract for Stella.
Good. Hey, Miranda, how come you don't look so happy about this?
Because I still don't understand why you chose to partner with Stella. Have you forgotten what Anna did to us in the past? What if she double-crosses us? Aren't you afraid Stella will lie to us the way she did?
Come on, Stella and Anna are two different people.
Salvador, but what else do we know about that woman, huh? You know, Stella was gone for almost 10 years now. Then all of a sudden, she keeps coming to us. To be honest, we don't even know anything about her, aside from her basic information. Doesn't that make her so suspicious? What if she's up to something, Salvador?
Miranda, the way I see Stella, she doesn't seem to have any evil intentions. She's a famous figure. She's from a well-respected family, so I really don't think she's out to get us. And above all, she's totally supportive of my platform. Her concern for the masses is genuine, and that's what makes her so easy to manipulate. Which means I can exploit her, then dispose of her once she's no longer of use to me.
Grandma.
Hello, dear. Why are you home early?
Well, I finished my papers and homework early, and I didn't have anything else to do, so I just went home, Grandma.
Why do you seem so down today? Tell me, are you sick?
Grandma, that photo Gail showed us last night, that was Anna, right?
Tantan, people like Gail are good at lying and manipulative. What if he just hired a model who looked identical to your sister, my boy?
But Grandma, I really can't be wrong. I know it's her. I've seen her face every day since I was a kid, so I'm definitely sure. Besides, I know you're thinking the same thing as I am.
If it's really her, then why didn't she reach out to us? And what's more, she looked so different now.
I don't know either. I'm sure she has her reasons, Grandma. Think about it. This is our chance to finally find out the truth. Don't you want to know what happened to my sister? Or where Dad is? Grandma, this is our only chance to find out what really happened to them.
Sam.
Gaeli.
Sam.
Hmm?
What are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be resting after what you did yesterday?
I told you, right? I'm fine. And Mom invited me for lunch. Why don't you join us?
Sam, I can't. I still have a lot to take care of after that landslide.
Aid for the victims?
Yes, but I'm not as concerned about that anymore because Stella's on it.
What do you mean?
Well, Godfather's already formed a partnership with Stella.
What? Is that even wise? I mean, we've only met this woman just recently.
I know, but they're equipped to help Godfather with his projects, and they're offering their services pro bono, which means we won't have to spend any more.
All I'm saying is, this woman's arrival into our lives is totally sudden and uncanny, don't you think so? What if she isn't sincere in helping us?
Sam, you're starting to sound like my mother. And it ends here. Besides, if they really aren't that trustworthy, then wouldn't it be better to keep an eye on them this way? If anything happens, it'll be easier for us to expose them.
Hold on, keep an eye on them? Or Stella?
Don't start with this again, Sam. I have a long day ahead of me and have a lot to finish today.
Who's that?
Just one of our staff. I have to go. You and our baby take care. Hello?
Senator, there are reports circulating that the mining site owned by your wife is what caused the devastating landslide in the town of San Sebastian. As of the moment, there are a lot of civil rights groups who are criticizing your current projects in that area. What can you say about these reports and comments, Senator?
Susie, it's unfair to blame my wife's company for that tragic landslide. The soil slipped because it was saturated by the rainfall. That's the result of the investigation. That's why we shouldn't... I'm sorry, but that's all I'm going to say about that issue.
Do you think DMO's mining operations contributed to the landslide? Because it destroyed the structure of the soil in that town?
No, DMO complied with the rules and regulations laid down by the government regarding the mining.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where these reports are coming from. I guess I just have a lot of enemies. But, I don't know. If I really didn't care, I wouldn't have asked my partner's firms to dispatch their ambulances to the disaster areas.
These partners you're referring to, Senator, are they Mr. Zander and Stella Guerrero?
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Guerrero. Actually, the local government asked them to send more ambulances there because there were a lot of people who needed help following the tragic accident. And not only that, Susie, my only daughter,
yes.
Samantha, she was there too, by chance. And that she even risked her life to, you know, rescue one of the men there who was affected by the landslide. Now I don't have any hidden agenda here. I'm not doing this for my image or anything. I just want to help, that's all.
Anyway, Senator, there are some people who think that due to the landslide, well, you might not push through with your other programs and projects, which you previously assured the town of San Sebastian. And because of this, some of the communities you promised to help are uncertain of their future.
No, that's not true. In fact, that's the reason we went to those thriving communities, Susie, okay? And we saw their situation, especially after the tragic accident, the landslide that took place. We realized that these communities really needed our help. Because of that incident, we're now more determined to help them all. So, to the residents of San Sebastian, please do not worry. I'm right here to help you. And will continue to help you. And I will never leave you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Senator. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Is there something you want to tell me?
About what?
About Gael's comments earlier. What was that?
He was trying to catch me again.
What do you mean?
Just as always, he tries to talk to me like I'm Anna. He flirts with me, and sometimes he refers to me as if I really were Anna.
What a scum. He's a married man, right?
I know what you mean. I thought about that too, but I figured maybe he's still in love with Anna.
In that case, you should humor him.
What?
Just play along with what he wants.
Xander, come on. Why would I do that?
Well, if your suspicion is correct, we can use him to finally infiltrate the world of the Del Mundos.
I'm sure that Grandma Pudding will like these cabbages I bought for her. My gosh, they're so fresh and crisp, just like me! Oh my goodness!
But why? Can't you do it? Hold on. Don't tell me you still have feelings for him until now.
I don't, Xander.
Well, that settles it then.
It's Emmy. Hello, Emmy?
Hello, Bestie Love. We have a problem, a very big one, in fact.
What's going on? What problem? Emmy, wait, hold on. Will you please calm down?
It's Grandma Pudding and San San. They were taken by men I've never seen before, and they took them in a van.
What? Did you see their faces?
No, I didn't, Anna. How about you? Who do you think they work for?
You think that they're Guile's men? Anna, I'm so sorry I wasn't able to protect them.
Grandma. Tantan, thank you for granting my request.
As long as you keep your promise, Gael.
So where's Anna?
Take it easy, Tantan. Promise you'll see her soon. Come on, let's go inside.
You don't want to fight fair, do you? You even dragged my family into this.
Well, if Gael had Anna's family abducted, then this only means that Gael already knows Stella is Anna.
Well, the plan failed, and we haven't even started yet. We're already busted.
Gael doesn't know the truth. If he had, he would have told Salvador about it right away. We wouldn't have been able to leave his office alive.
Then what's this? What do you think he'll use those two for?
As bait. He's using Anna's grandmother in Tantan to lure her out of her den. Unfortunately, Salvador has done this before. If he couldn't hurt you at all, he'll hurt your family.
Looks like Salvador has been teaching Gael. And I must say he taught him very well. He's become as ruthless as him. Melchor, Chito, go meet with Anna's friend. Find out what really happened earlier. Then track down the places where they could have possibly taken Tantan and Grandma Puring.
All right.
Anna, don't you worry. We'll do everything we can to find your family soon.
Is that the place where Anna's friend lives?
Yes, Uncle M, this is it. She said Emmy lives here.
Emmy.
Well, I just hope she hasn't left her house yet, or else Miss C won't be happy if we don't get to talk to her.
Hey! Who the heck are you? And why are you here? What are you doing here? Did Gael send you?
No, Gael didn't send us.
Can you please put that away? Please calm down.
Who are you then?
Anna sent us to talk to you.
Anna?
Yeah, can you please put that away now?
Yes, Anna sent us. Tell us everything that happened. And we'll be the one to find Grandma Puring and Tantan.
Anna! Anna, that's enough. Let me look at that. Stop it. You're hurting yourself.
I'm fine. Did you find my family?
We have no news yet.
Didn't you promise you would find them? You promised me that they wouldn't get involved in any of this, but look what happened! Gael has them! If something happens to them, I don't know what I'll be capable of doing.
Anna, that's enough. Don't worry, we'll find them, that's for sure.
Missy, do you know how it feels like to be useless? Until when will I feel this way?
Anna!
Anna!
Anna, don't! Hold on! Don't tell me you're going to ambush Gael. Give me that. Come on.
He took my family, so I need to do this, Xander.
Then what? You're going to waste your life just like that? Come on.
I don't think my life will be wasted. I'm willing to die for the sake of my family. I can't risk losing someone I love so much. I know you guys won't understand how I feel.
No, you're wrong. We do understand you. I know exactly how you feel, Anna. Salvador killed my father, just like what happened to you not long ago. Because the day my father died, I had nothing but anger in my heart. That anger consumed me. The only thing I wanted to do in my life was to kill Salvador. But I realized there was no point in it. I realized that the only way we could destroy Salvador is by exposing his crimes and put him in jail.
Anna, if you leave this place with that gun in your hand, the sacrifices your father made would all be for nothing, do you understand? Your family would only get into more trouble if you do this. Anna, have faith in our plan. Trust me, we can save your family, okay? We will be able to give justice to your father's death. That I assure you. Keep the faith.
know this place isn't that great, Grandma, but you'll find everything you need here. I can't take you to a hotel either because other people might spot you there.
We're fine staying here. But you better keep your promise to us. Take us to my granddaughter.
I always keep my word, Grandma Burin. I will take you to Anna. But first I have to find her.
Wait, I thought you said you already found her.
Well, something like that. But she's still in hiding and I can't bring her out.
You bastard, now you're using us as bait!
If my granddaughter really is hiding, then she must have a reason. You've humiliated her in front of everyone. I knew it, you were just planning to do something bad to Anna. Come on, let's go.
Do you really want to miss this opportunity to see her again? This is your only chance.
If this will only hurt her, then I would rather leave, Gael.
I'm not going to hurt Anna.
And why should we even believe you now, huh?
Because we all want the same thing, okay? To find out the truth, Tantan. And only Anna can answer her questions.
Let's go now.
Grandma Burin, Tantan. I know I've caused your family so much pain in the past. All I'm asking you now is to give me a chance to fix my mistakes and the choices I've made before. And to make it up to you.
Alright, I'll give you a chance. But remember, this will be the last chance I'm giving you. I just hope you don't disappoint us.
Thanks, Grandma. I want you to make sure that those two won't escape this place. Tie them up if they resist. Do you understand? Yes, sir.
What? They're not in the warehouse in Marikina? Okay, fine. Then go check out the Del Mundo's warehouse we saw just recently in Cubao. With your Uncle Melchor. Just let me know what you find out, okay? All right.
Missy, what is this?
I asked Chito to check out all the verified warehouses owned by the Del Mundos, in case your family were brought and kept hostage in one of them.
Wait, isn't that dangerous? What if Gael finds out? He might move them somewhere else before Chito even finds them.
Anna, calm down. We've been sneaking into Del Mundo's warehouses for a long time, so don't worry. Melchor and Chito know what they're doing, all right?
No. No, this still doesn't feel right. I'm starting to get nervous. I should have gone with them, Missy.
Then what? Anna, you'll only be recognized by Salvador's men. And that will just put your family in greater danger.
Missy, I'm going insane here. I feel useless. They're out there looking for my family while I'm just here.
Anna, when your real father died, I swore to myself at that time that I would find his family and protect them at all costs. So I promise you, I won't ever make the same mistake again, do you hear me? I won't allow the only family you have to get hurt. We're going to save them, okay?
What's this?
Apparently, the townspeople were overjoyed by the support you gave them in their time of need. So now they're inviting you to a party as an expression of their gratitude.
It'll just be a small celebration, Salvador. But I think it'll be a good idea if we go. We can definitely use this occasion to strengthen our ties with the community.
Well, you should go, Salvador.
Okay. But I do not want too many people from the press around.
And why not? It's your time to shine, Salvador.
I don't want the people thinking this is all some campaign move for the election.
Yes. Present an image of a humble hero. That's a great idea.
Miranda, come on. A little propriety, please. We don't have to treat every occasion as a campaign opportunity. By any chance, was Salvador the only one invited to the recognition event? Perhaps we should also invite Stella.
And why would we do that, Hillary?
They're the ones who responded first to the disaster in San Sebastian. So I think it's only right to thank them.
Well, they were just doing their job, that's all. Now, just because the Master is being praised doesn't mean his soldier, who has been tailing behind him all day, should also be commended and given a medal.
Miranda, I think you've totally forgotten that we hadn't accepted their proposal yet when the tragic landslide incident happened. Which means that, at that time, they offered their assistance voluntarily.
Okay. Invite them as well.
Are you serious, Salvador?
Well, the Guerreros are our partners now, so we must invite them. Besides, it's better if the public saw them so they can see and be made aware that my community development projects are on their way.
You do realize they won't be the only ones there, right? Carlota Candelaria is acting as the Guerreros' business consultant. Invite her or not, she'll definitely be at the social event. Do you really want to be associated with that lunatic?
But Carlota has a certain charm. And I don't see any reason for her to be a hindrance to us, Miranda. And besides, isn't it your job as Salvador's PR head to make sure that she doesn't pose any threat or get in Salvador's way? Just go to your job, okay?
Okay. Just invite them, please. And, well, anyway, I'm sure the public is going to look for the people who helped me during the rescue operation, so let them come. Instead of arousing suspicion, we should just invite them. It might also help with my image.
Fine. If that's what you want. But, I'm still not sure if you should be seen associating with them. We still don't know them that well, Salvador.
We'll get to know them eventually. They're our partners now, okay? Miranda, you're being too paranoid. And from what I see from them, they don't seem to have a hidden agenda against us. So chill. Good thing you came home, Gael.
Why are you dressed like that? Are you going out?
We have an appointment with the doctor. Don't tell me you forgot about it. So you did forget about our checkup.
Sam, please don't start with me. I just had a long night, so ask Grasha to go with you to the hospital. They need me at the mining site.
But why? Is my friend Grasha the father of this child? Ugh! You know what? Tell me. Are you really busy with work at a DMO, Gaeli?
Sam, is this what you want again? Do you want to fight this early in the morning? I'm fulfilling my obligations to this family, so stop making all sorts of accusations.
I have the right to do so. I'm your wife. You know what? What's the point, right? If you won't listen anyway. All I can say is this, Gael, so listen. I hope you find time to fit your family into your very busy schedule the way you promised me before. Because the last time that I checked, we're supposed to be your number one priority.